Did she cross it upper? Did it travel? Yeah, something about that traveling in her. And was there a lot of transfusions with her? Like, I'm seeing actual physical blood transfusions. If she didn't have them, it could be somebody else.
No.
Oh, who's this? Who had the blood transfusions?
Mine.
All right. You see how fast they're getting now? They're really moving me around the room. That's good. We want that. Well, you were there. She shows rubbing her forehead, all right? So I don't know if that was in the final moments, but she definitely knows you were there doing that. The forehead means a lot. Did she lose eyebrows or something? Why did she turn her eyebrows? Or are they your eyebrows? I can't see your eyebrows, but is she fussy about her eyebrows?
My daughter is.
Oh! She's pointing you out. She said, holy heaven. She says she hears you all the way up there. When they're not right, she is not happy. She said they're beautiful. Don't worry about them, okay? They're beautiful. That's right. Girls gotta have confidence. See that? Don't forget anybody. Does somebody have her jacket? And her jacket? Where was I? Where were those girls? Okay. Jacket? You have mom's jacket?
I do have two of her jackets, yeah.
Okay. Do you have somebody else's jackets or just mom's jackets? Because I heard jackets, but you were a little...
So, the only thing that rings a bell with jackets is that my family has, like, celebrity backgrounds with Jennifer Jones, and she was very proud of this one jacket, and we had gotten a jacket after she had passed, so... Mm-hmm.
I think that's a jacket we're talking about. That has a lot of weight to it. You know what I mean? Was the jacket heavy too? Was that a fun?
It was a very, like,
heavy jacket?
It was hot.
Yeah, I think that was not just me saying it had a lot of weight to it. It's not really the way I would say something, so it was heavy jacket. Yeah. And, what is she saying? Is there something about lipstick or lip gloss or? Is that you?
Mm-hmm.
You always putting it on or something?
Well, I kept it for forever. I felt very wrong.
Hers? That's what she said. Mm-hmm. Thank you. She said, thank you, honey. I love you. I love you. I love you. She's holding her hand. I love you. Bree, dragonflies? She like dragonflies? They're all buzzing around your head right now. All right. Almost like if they could make a... Did your head buzz or something? Why is she giving me this? She's making me feel like a buzz around the head. Was that something she dealt with or you did? Okay. No, she says, Mom, you can buzz too. And she smiled. Okay. She wants you to know that she fits into her old clothes and you'll know what that means. And she tells me to thank you for being there for her. So who are you to her? Oh, okay. Have we ever met? We did meet once,
yeah.
Didn't we?
I remember a long time ago.
Now, is your dad in spirit? All right, because I'm hearing dad. And he's like a big bear, and he's giving her a hug. And he says, I don't want you to worry. I got her. I know you know, and you will... He said, you're going to get mad at him for saying this, but you're going to get used to it. He knows he shouldn't say it like that, but he doesn't know any other way to say it, okay? So she said, forgive him. But, you know, there's a lot of emotion with this situation, and he doesn't want you to take it like he's being, that's how he's got to express himself, right? And is your mother in spirit, too? Did she... Wish she could have got her hair done before she went there or something. Did she like? Oh my God! Really? Yeah, learned something new about her. Now that I did not know. More on the dragonfly. She's holding hands. She's got two women on each side of her. oh, it's Brittany. There's a Brittany. And they want to say something about the water park. Are you going somewhere where there's a water park? Or are you?
We're going on.
Oh my God, no, they have water parks on those darn ships these days. Yeah, because it's like, we're going, and so they're going, and they're free. Yeah, a lot of free vacations in heaven. She says, Mommy, I love you too. Does anyone, somebody wants to show me apples? I didn't forget Susie, by the way, that just came back. Is there anything about apples with Susie? Is that where I'm going? Apples. And do you think you know what that means? Is that with her or somebody else?
I don't even know.
So it's almost like if someone had, like you have to get the bushels of apples, or you go get the apples, or you pick the apples.
I'm really confused. I talked to somebody before and told me about apples.
People that cheat on me. See, I don't. You know, I hope you don't. Well, there's got to be. Do you have someone that has an apple tree? Because I'm seeing it like bushels of apples. Like,
yes, my great grandparents had
apple orchards. That means there's bushels.
Then
this would be that your great grandparents probably really want you to know that their presence is with you. And that's why they would do that, because, and especially when they use other mediums for it, their way of basically saying, oh, you know, oh, she's going to get it one of these times, you know? And she'll remember that we had apple orchards. I think you'll never see those again. But are you guys connected? All right, because I felt like the Susie person said something about the car, and I don't know what she's talking about. I mean, I don't know if that's how she passed or something. As her car, or what's going on?
No.
Did she drive? Was she old enough to drive?
Mm-hmm. That's what she did.
She drove more.
Yeah. Her dad drove her everywhere she wanted to go. She never drove.
She couldn't drive, but
she could drive. She could.
Got it. Okay. She might be referencing, is dad in spirit or is dad still living?
He's still there.
No. Is there something of her in the car that he has? Does he have something hanging or he carries something?
Yeah, there's a cross in her rosary.
That's what she's talking, because she's got me there busy.
It's an angel, actually.
Okay, yeah. She wanted, like, that reference, and she got it across, so she would probably be out of the car for sure. You know, I don't know. I just feel like my head falls back. I don't know how she passed, but I almost just feel like I'm like that. Was she found that way, or sleep, or?
She was really weak and sick, and we didn't really know how sick. It was too late.
Okay.
She really knew what was going on.
Okay. Yeah.
You know, she didn't know.
Yeah, that's probably, I mean, just that feeling of, you know, my head falling back, and that would be a weakness. I could understand her using that. Nobody has her pants, do they? She's kind of funny with these pants going. She's laughing. What's that?
I have a pair of her pants.
Thank you. The traveling pants is like, that was the view I got, like when someone's calling up the pants. Say the pants. Okay. So basically trying to prove to you she's here is what she's doing. She's very misty still. She's very swirly. Is she a lighthearted person? She's got a blanket that she loves to show. Does somebody have a blanket connection with her?
She'd always have one.
She'd always have it wrapped around? Because that was the view. It was like, if I had the blanket wrapped, I would just, you won't want me to swirl. I might fall off. But that's what she's showing me. And she's just saying, I love you guys. And does somebody always read the newspaper or penny saver or something? Is someone she'd either watch over or someone that might be with her? You know when you see the little town things, and they're usually, and they got typing in them? It was in there. Something was written in there. Did somebody do a write-up on her? Everybody gets something written up, I think.
I write her a letter almost every single day.
Who does? You guys write her?
I write her about over 100 letters in the last 4 months.
It might be what she's getting at, because she's showing me writing. I mean, that, it felt like it was typed. Do you type it?
No.
Anyone type? Yeah, that, it seemed like I had type print. So I don't want to take away how she showed it, but she might add to it. And she said the Christmas tree. Christmas tree. I mean, we passed it, but was there something special about the Christmas tree? Or?
Well, they had their first Christmas tree in 10 years. This year my dad did, and she's gone. But I bought him a Christmas tree.
This was the first
year?
We bought
ornaments and stuff.
That's what she's talking about. That's very important to them up there. Sometimes when there's never been a tree or something special, but for her to go see the Christmas tree, she wants you to know that she does see. And I consider that a thing, honestly. What was that? What's that mean? Is there a Salvatore? Are you raising your hand? Oh, sorry. Don't do that. Do you have a mother in that little mom in spirit? The one that just like accused you of raising your hand? Is your mom in spirit?
Yeah.
She got you. Mm-hmm. I don't know who Salvatore belongs to, but was there something about doing the cookies?
Mm-hmm.
Because she's got the white dough or whatever, doing the cookies. And she's saying something about her shoes. Have her shoes, or are you fussy about shoes, or did you get new shoes for tonight?
No, I have all my mom's shoes.
You have your mom's shoes? That might be your mom then. Let me just go.
Hey, Sally.
Why did I say Sal? I said Sal. Didn't I? That's a Sal. Well, they're all talking back to me. So you have Sal, you have all her shoes. That's your mom making sure, you know, she's not going to let me leave there without saying that. But your mom said something, I don't remember what, I can't go backwards, but is there something about embroidery? Back one. Anything with embroidery? Somebody doing embroidery?
No.
All right, how about your mom? Did she do any embroidery or somebody that would be with her? Somebody's really doing a lot of embroidery.
Oh, my grandfather did.
Who was he?
My grandfather was a tattoo artist. But that's not a word.
No. Funny, it could be like that. But I'm getting somebody has something about embroidery. Say, I feel you have something. Like somebody has it. Not we have it here.
Cross stitch.
Oh, well, that same thing, especially yeah. For me. I don't know what that stuff is.
My grandmother cross stitched.
And you're right. Okay. I think that, yeah, they're really quick. Yeah, and you have some of it. Huh? Yeah, that's yours. This is your grandma?
Mm-hmm.
Did her and your grandfather like to dance?
Probably when they were younger.
No, I'm seeing
over here.
Dancing is very important. What's the dancing? We like to dance. Go ahead, put it out. They'll correct you if it's not them, trust me. Do you like ballroom dance or something? Nothing like this though.
Oh,
yeah. Oh Lord, that's you got it with you. That right now is yours, I'm pretty sure, at this moment. But you do the dance, do this dance. I don't know something about the dance.
I did ballroom dance.
That's the dancing I'm talking about. Now, when you were younger, you said?
My wedding.
And I'm talking to your mom, then you have the embroidery thing or grandma?
No, a friend made it for me.
Oh, and your grandma's spirit.
My friend is here. She made it for me because someone else is in the spirit.
Well, then that's what that is. You're trying to be tricky now with your people.
No.
You know that definitely goes with that, okay? That embroidery and you have it. They were making me say you have it. That was very specific to me. And if no one says anything, then I just try to move along, and then somebody else gets credit, and then they start adding to it, and that's why that happens. But the person about the embroidery, I just feel, how much in my heart, I don't know if that's, you know what it means, probably more than I do. Sorry, microphone. And you did the ballroom dancing, though, so who's the closest person that would know that? Because that was important in that message. So that's something personal, not just anybody's going to tell me that about it. the wedding, or they would have watched over it anyway. So, is there one of them you wish was at the wedding, or you think of them with your wedding? Because that's important, your ballroom dancing, and they, you know, you saw me up here doing it. And that means somebody's showing me that from their heart. So they would either be telling you they want you to see that you did that, or that they were there and they're a part of that memory. So that's the only reason I would say. Alice. Who's Alice?
We're here.
We got Alice is all over. Is that your name, Alice?
Oh.
We got someone calling out Alice's name. Let's see what's going to happen. Is your dad in spirit? All right. And is there also, now I'm either getting someone calling you mom, or I got moms in spirit. Which way are you taking it? Your mom's in spirit too. And do you have a spouse in spirit? A spouse? Who's a younger male in spirit? There it is. That's the son. How old was your son? He's like... Yeah, he's young. I feel like he's just like kneeling there. And that's what I mean. I knew I had a young, that's your son. And he takes your hand. He says, Mom, I'm okay. All right? He wants you to really leave the pain here tonight. I'm okay. He said, I'm pretty smart, Mom. You know that about me. All right? I didn't always act. Oh, Lord. I like your son. Sorry I have to meet him this way, but you're really smart. Yeah, you're a smart aleck. Yeah, they get me to say it in the way they get me to say it. And he knew you would, you know, sometimes it's afraid anymore. I kind of adjusted up here. Let me go on. No, I was really, that's what that's about. He gives you a rose, all right? And I don't know who you are to him, but he said, hey, and he just looked at you. And he put his head down. Who are you to him?
I'm not her son, but her son-in-law's my brother.
All right. There are a lot of emotions. There's emotions about passings, obviously, and I know that. But was there something disruptive? Did it disrupt everything the way he passed?
He was old enough to suffer for 10 years.
A long time. And it probably did. I would say by what he's making me feel, you know what I mean? And a lot of people bent and went above and beyond for him. And he's grateful for that. He shows me his legs, and I don't know if that's part of what he dealt with, but. Is he in a wheelchair here? Anybody that's in a wheelchair out there? Not anymore. Who's that, yours? Your mother was in a wheelchair? Hanging out with their people. That's what happens. Yeah, because I did see it and I did feel the legs were. trying to tell me some food, Mom. I don't know what it is, though. I'm kind of feeling sure. Is there something about goulash? Did he like goulash? Yeah. That's another food. We haven't had much food. That was what it was. So, simple stuff, but it's his way of telling me he's with you. I hope you can feel me. Anybody have a Simon? That's not a common name. Do you have a Bruce? Troublemaker? No. Who has Bruce right here?
My husband.
In spirit. But they're all living? All right, well, it'd be somebody very connected and mutual to all of you giving me that name then, which means they're thinking of it. Yeah. All right, so who's the closest male to you in spirit that's going to say that? Is there a dad in spirit?
Yeah.
Is it
Bruce?
Your dad? Oh, Bruce's father? All right, and he's in spirit. You've really got me around the block here, but I'm leaving it up to them to say it. Bill, he's our Bill. He had more fun with the name Bruce, and obviously we know why, because there's so many people named Bruce. He says, well, I'm here. I'm hearing abdomen. Is that him or somebody else? And he's in spirit? Okay. Well, he might even be saying Bruce. You know. Yeah, I mean, he knows that you got all that Bruce energy around you guys living. Yeah, but I'm all here, and it just, it's very discomforting. But he's not of that anymore, and you know that, okay? Did he bleed in that area? I mean, is there, you know, I'm not sure how, what it is, but he's making me see that as well. Okay. He says he needed to learn to let things go more. Don't hold on to things. Let things go. He's learning that. There's things that the family still has to let go of, too, by the way. So I don't know. He's watching the family, you know. I'm not usually going to give me your details, but you shouldn't, really. It's more of a personal message, I think. But just to let things go, to be okay. And he doesn't mean himself. You know that, right? And who would be Joe? Oh, Joe, like Josephine? Okay. All right. She's saying, she always wear little earrings. What's up with you? What's up with the earrings? Why don't you say that? Maybe earrings. Somebody have earrings from someone, or got a gift, or do you have somebody else?
Who? Mm-hmm.
And Louise gave you the earrings? Yeah, that, see how they're lining up. That's what they're doing. We're here too. We're here too. We're here too. Talking myself a lot, sorry. They're saying something though. Somebody's saying something. What are you trying to tell me? Was there something built in the backyard for somebody, or a little area where they're, I don't know if they're there, but they're little things for them, a little tribute to them? Aunt Jo? That's her. Because she sees it's tribute. But I can see it's like outside. She does see it, okay? Do you have her recipes?
No, but she has my husband's recipes.
All right, well then that's her. All right, and that's her saying hi to you. She said use them. Or do you use them? And she's telling you. Yeah, all right. Is there a Stephanie? Steph, are you Stephanie or is there a Stephanie there? Uh-oh, they're calling your name out. See, you can't get away from it when they do that, you know. What's up with the Wheel of Fortune game? Is there somebody like that TV show? Or do they both like Wheel of Fortune? Well, that's obviously them merging on you here to say hello, and they love you very much, all right? And is there something about... Is there one of them that you were like in their drawer and you were trying to get things organized and help? Because they show you. Yeah. One of them was messy, but one of them wasn't. You didn't have two neat ones or two messy ones. Yeah, one and one. Okay. Yeah. Is there a Larry? Two? Lawrence? Any Larrys? Even if you're not connected, that's okay. No Larry? Okay. Well, your grandmother was definitely saying hi, but I also see the quilt, and I don't know which one. The quilt, say the quilt. We got another grandmother popping in. Do you have a mother in spirit right here? Does she have a quilt? Or you have her quilt? Or you stuck with the quilt? Your grandma, yeah, because I knew when I looked right at you, it was. That's when I saw the quote, but I thought I was still there. All right, well, they're saying hello to you, you know, and you're always cold right here. I know you got it on you, so we'll scratch that one off, okay? We won't count it. Because you're all wrapped up, but they do know you're always cold. And you have a gentleman that would drink a little something. He told me to tell you to warm up and have a little sip. Something good in that glass. I don't know what it is. But is that Dad? Who are the trains? Anybody right there? Someone's got me on the train. Anybody with the train with you? Worked on a train? Felt like I was coming to you a minute ago. Oh, who's the train? That's the guy, yeah. That's the kind of thing. He's in it, you know what I mean? And they're moving along. All right, well, that's him. I don't know if he came in when I was over here, but he's saying hi to you. You got someone, you have their hat? Say a hat. You any other hat?
I have.
And he's in spirit? All right, then I'm right there. He has planted or just happened to be sitting there? Oh, well, then you know him too, right? You just don't have the hat. Yeah. All right, so the hat went in the air. And is there anything about like water sports or anyone they watch over or anything? Sometimes it's childhood memories, sometimes you'd be surprised. All right, so he probably, maybe part, yeah, because it felt like water skiing, you know? And he's in spirit? All right, so you're getting the whole little, I knew it was coming to you. Okay, go there, but nothing. Well, they're all saying hi, so know that, all right? And do you still live near the lake? He's telling me there's an algae problem, and he sees it. What lake were you? Cuba? If they could only purify it for us. All right, well, he knows there's problems over there, he said. He should have paid attention. He likes nature. He's not happy about things like that. All right? Is there a Carl? Oh, who's Carl?
My father.
Okay. He laughed and said, finally. You should have known I'd say hello. All right. Did he play music or instrument or anything?
No.
Is there anyone else that he would watch over or next to him?
No.
I feel like I see a truck. She's my no lady. God. There are no no's, don't you? Bugle, trumpet, all of the, you know, her, your dad's going to go on, but I got to go with this instrument. If it's not him or someone he'd be watching over, is there anyone else here where you could understand this word? Going on here? Somebody, huh? Somebody really wants to play it. Was somebody in the army? Were you? Or anyone you'd be watching over? Oh, what's that? He played. That might be, because I just came from you. Yeah, it could be. I mean, feel like a bugle though. Nobody has anybody played a bugle or was there anything about taps? Oh, what's up? The bugle. Oh. Oh well, I think we got your bugle, your Carl, the bugle player. And your Carl and her Carl probably said hi to each other and that. But yeah, that was, you see how he lined up three things when you ignored me? He made sure you knew it was him. That's what happened. So this is definitely him. He got like three things right there. No, he's with you. He just tells me to tell her, no, I'm with him. I see an eagle, but that could be army, but it could be even more than that. No, he shows me an eagle flying. There's something about seeing the eagle, or do you like to see the eagle? Oh, Lord, you guys, I'm done. I don't even know where to go with that one now. Yeah, that's...
In the army, they did a tattoo of an eagle, and he did play the
They can wrestle up there for that one. I don't even know where to go. Sometimes when things like that are so... I mean, come on, just read details. It's almost like, how do I... I don't even know where to go with that. Yeah. The only thing that makes me think that I'm still here, though, is because I did feel it was the bird itself. So is there anything, like seeing the eagles or wherever? What do you think?
Yeah. I played three birds when my husband passed away.
This is, I knew something kept me. No, stay here. Stay here. All right. That's your husband and I. Of course he's in. I know, you should have brought her a rose. A lot of times spouses will bring roses in front of me. The bachelor has nothing on the spirit rose. But, and I haven't got any roses, so I wouldn't say you have a spouse because I didn't see it. He said, well, he whispers in your, he wants me to whisper it, but it's not. He says, I love you too. And I think you must have whispered in his ear because he makes me feel you did do that. So I want to say that you said, I love you, I love you. Now, is he somebody's brother that's here as well? Who's the... Oh, I'm back to him and the smart family. The smart family. Is he smart too, or no? He's another. Huh? He thought he was. Maybe that was where the comment originated, and then the brother. Yeah, All right, so they are saying hi, and, or he is saying hello, and I love you guys, is what I hear, I love you guys. Now, who would tap dance? Anybody? You are a tap dancer? What are the odds of that?
We are, oh, we're all tappers.
Get out! Nice little spot. Oh, that's cute. Now, who's the closest to you in spirit? Because that's who's telling you this.
My mom owned a dance studio, and I took it over, and she passed away.
Oh, is there ever the ballroom dancing was somewhere?
My mom and Dad both taught from ballroom.
Yeah, that was our whole little thing. Yeah, all right. A lot of families. Wayne? Anybody got a Wayne in spirit? Or a Wayne in room? Well, I got some sentence I gotta say. I don't know if it connects to Wayne or not. Some way it may, but. A young man, and he's saying it was not on purpose, it was an overdose. So, this was unknown. There were people wondering. It was not on purpose, it was an overdose. Okay, who was that to you?
My
nephew. All right, did he already come a little bit when I was talking? I'm just curious. All right, that's all right, because I know somebody had come, but sometimes they've said something and then they're you're not sure and they'll always bring me back to make sure. But that statement was very clear and I had to make sure I said it. It was not on purpose. But he just, I don't know, his chest is something. So I don't know if that's what happened. It's just got this pressure here, you know. But I really feel a sleeping state, you know. And he woke up and I feel Grandpa was in spirit. His grandfather, or his, it'd be his grandfather, but, and just looking over him and said, well, you're going to sit up now. So he was a firm man, and he told him he'll be okay, and everybody else will be too. But we got some things to show him. And he walked right into heaven. So I think people may have worried, is he okay? Was he in heaven? Did he go in? Sometimes there's some fears in those kind of passings, but he did. And he had some nice eyes too, he said. Right? He did. He had very nice eyes, and he went like this, through his muscles. So he seems thin, though. But he had muscles, but that made him feel stronger. He's learned a lot about life over in heaven. And he's very, 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 very connected to Jesus. Just in case, I don't know what your faith is, but I can tell you if you want me to say it. I know Jesus. Don't worry. Don't worry. And was he good at riding a bike, like, you know, a bicycle bike? Is there a funny story about him riding? Or? It's like when you ride, you fall, but you get back up real easy. I mean, he seems like something about that. That might be something you have to... Is there anybody get a BMX bike? What happened with the bike? He wanted to ride a bike? He went, what, the BMX time? That's it? That's what he's talking about then? I'm sure of it, but he's just showing it, and he's like, show it, you know? Thank you. Y'all tired? I'm starting to feel it a little, so that means they're probably going to slow down. I am hearing Rose, the name Rose. I'm going to go there first. Okay. Who's that to you, Mom, Grandma? Yeah, bring the mics.
My sister.
Your sister is Rose, and she's in spirit?
Mm-hmm. Rosie, though.
Rosie.
And you mentioned the word Prince, and you mentioned the word Simon, and those are the two patches.
Well, why didn't you say something?
I didn't. They were together.
Uh-huh.
She had Down syndrome.
Uh-huh. And she's, yeah, and you know, when you say those names, you know she's okay. Obviously, she's
healthy. Oh, I knew that.
Yes. But was she, did she have a thing with buttons? Like, she couldn't, or she didn't like them, or something?
She didn't like them. Oh. She never wore buttons, so I don't know. She never wore shirts with buttons.
Oh, well, because she's going like this, show buttons, so I think what she's saying is, yeah, you know, okay? And I also feel, did everyone do her hair for her?
Well, we didn't have people do her hair.
Yeah, she's saying that, and piano or organ or something.
When we were kids, we used to play them. She liked to play them.
She loves everybody so much. She's just one big
love
bug. She's saying love bug. Was she called there? Was there
she
something?
She might have been. I don't know.
Like the smart guy over there, you know, making me say something everybody makes me think it's more than I really know. A lot of that goes on, as you see here. Love bug. That means ladybug. What's up with ladybugs?
Nothing.
All right, we're moving then, probably. Yep. You got ladybug person? Who is that to?
My dad called me that.
Ladybug?
This little ladybug.
That's yours. So your mom's in spirit too? She's making sure you know that, obviously. I don't know if she came when I was with you originally. Yeah, because it's ladybug, show the ladybug. Somebody's showing me a camel. Oh, God, help me out. I saw a zebra the other day in a room, and the girl goes, I have a picture of this room, and there's a little girl, a zebra, and the mother's always on the refrigerator to this day when her mother had passed. And she said her mother was still in the refrigerator. She was, you know, 35 years old, this girl now. So, but her mother, it was her mother's favorite picture. So something like that. You got a camel? Do you have a spouse in spirit? Who's the male in spirit? Dad? Is dad in spirit? Did he smoke? That's your dad, see? Yeah, you have to say yes to the camel. And the camel. Probably was a llama, but they kind of look alike, you know? Was he police department or anything with that kind of work? Was there anyone else that would be, could have, I don't guess who's here? Who was that to? Oh, is somebody he's watching over then that works for the police department? Because he'd be watching over somebody if it isn't him himself. Is he in spirit? Oh, okay. Yeah, then he's acknowledging him, and that's your dad, and it's in spirit, so I think it's his grandson. Why am I seeing a whistle? Like the whistle, like a whistle. The whistle that you blow. I don't know if that's a policeman thing. I think it's something else. What is that with you? And who's the closest to you in spirit? The grandfathers are getting rowdy up there. Yeah, because that's very important in this vision to show the whistle. So he's letting you know. They're watching over him, which I'm sure you missed that. And is there a Maureen or a Morris or Maurice or something? Spirit first. Who's Maureen or Maureen?
Who?
Your mom got her name in.
Well, it's her middle name.
That's all right.
I made that her
at home. Oh, okay. That's why she's saying it. Your mom's quite the noisemaker in heaven, isn't she? Yeah, because sometimes, a lot of times they don't get their names or hard. There's no emotion in letters, so everything that comes in through these pictures is because of the emotion. Just like seeing the whistle, they're saying, oh, we want to know we're watching over. It's the whistle. There's still stuff here. Do you have? I can't think of the name of what I want to say. Not quilts, but the knitted ones. Who would knit? Afghans. I was saying, wait, everybody knows what I'm talking about? You have somebody with Afghans? Because I felt this one across the knees here. Like it wanted to be here. All right? And they love what you're doing. Whose Afghans do you have? Like moms or grandmas or something? Your mom made the Afghans? And is there a letter V connected to somebody up there? Van or what? Oh, Afghan, wow. No, I did see him on the knee right here. So I got to stay with that. But is there a Vince? Oh, who's that? The Heathen Spirit? That's yours. That's the whistle guy. He's making sure you know that. Afghan was on. Do you have one of the Afghans? Because it's actually physical, like when they're making. Yeah. All right, so she's making sure you know that. Do you have a rose as well? Do you have a rose in spirit as well? And the rose beans. Do you even have a spouse in spirit? That's your rose then. I thought I was getting the name this time. You're getting your spouse, okay? That's the rose that was coming right at you. He said he'd tell her I got dressed for this. So he either liked to dress up or didn't. There's usually no in between, all right? And he says you don't have to be afraid to ask for help. Ask for some help. Stop it. People are all around you and they love you. And he's a smart man. He got this thing called eternal life, and that's what this is all about. And we both believe in it. So don't stop because my body is. Still look at the side of the bed. You go, I think you may even go like that. Because he's making the bed. He knows he's there. Alright? Did he like cream of wheat or oatmeal or something? Wheaties? Cream of Wheaties, alright. Yeah. Alright. And is there a letter M around you? I hope that's his name or somebody else. But. Thank you. Yeah. Her name is. Oh, are they still with us? All right, so he's watching over them. That's because that was a big M. And that's Kayla and Nolly. Hmm? All right, I'd say that that's probably what he's really addressing that he watched over. Because it was a big M, and that's usually a push for me to say, please, you know, say this, get this in. All right? Did he like graham crackers? Huh? No, they're not normal graham crackers. Saltines are normal. No. Well, I just saw graham crackers, so I had to say, wait. Graham cracker crust? Is there something about pies? Hey, the pies? That's your pies. Do you use graham cracker or will you not use that? Yeah, there's something about that, though. They got me to pies. In their graham cracker? I know, who would think graham cracker crust would start such a commotion, but that's heaven for you up there. There's something for things that bring. Going to the casino. Not me. Somebody in heaven is talking about it up there. Are you guys going to the casino? When after here, are you waiting to get out so you can go gamble? When are you going? Oh, well, you're going to have some fun. Don't forget Lucky 7. Oh, Lord. Everybody run and play 7 now. I mean, isn't that a famous number? I don't gamble, obviously. That'll try it, though. Everybody's got to go. Okay. I'm going to do a little meditation, and I do get information during the meditation. So please think of a thought or something, or someone who maybe didn't say anything that you wished would. Put that thought out while I'm just guiding you right now, because you'd be surprised some of the things that are going to come in during the meditation, closing meditation. I'm going to have you close your eyes for a moment. Just take some nice slow breaths. As you breathe, back to all the light that's been around you. And bring this light back in. So every pore in your body opens, this light enters through the cells, the systems, back into your hearts, this slow breath. Carry this light with you in all the light of spirit. love, strength, all the wisdom that they share in their heart. Call upon this light each day, simply bringing your awareness to it and letting it flow through and around. Things I want to put out. I felt like I heard the name Wilbur. I don't know if anybody has a Wilbur. I also felt like I heard the name Carolyn or Carolyn or something. I also saw someone who was a mechanic, and I feel somebody has his tools, and he was grateful about that. That wherever the tools went, they needed to go. So, and the other, a beautiful white house with pillars, and I see roses, and I feel this is someone's home or somewhere where they grew up. And I won't forget the fishing bowls. And I saw some fishing bowls, and they said they have the fishing bowls. And it was a man who said, "I got my fishing bowls." So I think they were either handed down to people. So I don't know if anybody wants to raise their hand on that, but or if it was something you were thinking. But it was coming in. Fishing bowls seem kind of important to somebody up there. Make sure you know they know. Is there a Cody by the name of Cody? Someone by the name of Cody? Either here or in spirit?
No, but my neighbor's name was Carol.
She was Carol?
Yeah.
All right, so she got her name.
My daughter's name is
Carol. Okay, thank you. And is there any, no Cody, huh? That name's not common. Oh, thank you. Do you have a Cody in spirit?
No, a dog.
Oh, a dog in spirit? Okay. Were you hoping Cody would come in?
Hoping for anybody.
Do you have a Frank? How about your mom? Is she in spirit?
Yeah.
Yeah? Hang on there. I don't need to tag on this jacket. Have you guys been watching me walk? Oh, no. I forgot to cut it off. Oh, my. I bought this for tonight, too. Yeah. Bought the pants or something. The jeans. Did mom have a recliner, or do you have her had her recliner, or am I getting somebody else? Do you have somebody else up there that had the recliner? Say the recliner. I really thought it was, what was that to you? She always had a recliner?
She had a recliner.
What was that?
She had my mother's recliner.
Oh, okay. So that would be your mom bringing that in for her. Yeah, it was all about the recliner. And I feel a gentleman, and he says something about the fence, and I do think it's with you that said Cody, there's something about the fence. Show her the fence. So if you have a gentleman up there, put the fence, fix the fence, or you need to fix the fence or something.
My dad was always in the recliner watching football.
And he's in spirit?
Yeah.
Yeah. See, that's where I felt I was, and when you didn't want it. Now, are you connected to her, or are you?
Yes.
Yes, so it is then.
Okay.
And do you have, did he hate mustard or love mustard, or what's up with mustard? Food is a love-hate thing, no in between. Anything with mustard?
I guess there was for ketchup.
He what?
For ketchup.
He likes ketchup? Is he being a smart aleck? And is there anybody, you in the gray hood shirt there behind me? Anybody who played pool or shooting pools in memory? What's that?
I shoot pool.
Oh, she's good. I guess she's good.
I'm very good.
Are you connected to them next to you, or you just happen to be sitting? Right. Somebody that would know you well would want to say that, so I don't know who's up there who would hope to be here, but that's what's going to tell me. Is there a young guy up there?
Great.
Who is that to you?
My sister's ex.
Yeah, I felt like he had his hand on his head, and he's like, hey. So he's just giving you that kind of, hey. All right.
I have something.
Huh?
I have something.
No X and out spirit. No X and no in-laws, no staff. It all merges. That's what they teach me. Well, thank you, everyone. I appreciate your. I appreciate your, you know, being here and supporting this wonderful cause. Madam Clerk, Chris Palooza there, where are you? Major Palooza. Thank you. I will thank you all very much.